Hey guys, I'm back, and today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to play competitive Fortnite, because I am a competitive player and I play a lot of, you know, cups and stuff. So I just finished doing the Lightning Cup. Well, I didn't finish. I'm going to do two more matches, and I got two kills, but I'm going to be teaching you guys how to play competitive Fortnite, because some people, you know, don't know how to play competitive Fortnite, really. So, to play competitive Fortnite, you don't just land at a hot drop all the time, because there's a lot of sweaty players in the arena and stuff, and cops. This is not like souls and shooters. It's more sweaty people. By the way, they just added this new mode in arena. But I'm gonna be playing the cup while I'm teaching you guys how to play competitive Fortnite. So. So, to play competitive Fortnite, you don't, as I was saying, the first thing is you don't want to just land a hot drop, because there's more sweatier players in like cups and tournaments and stuff, because they have like 2FA and like, you know, all that stuff, continual championship. So, these are all pro players, you know, like all those pro players like Booga, Clix, you know, Mongo, Benji Fushi, and all of those players, right? To play competitive Fortnite, so we all know the first step was don't land at hot drops. Land somewhere like in the middle of nowhere, like literally land somewhere basically in the middle of nowhere. So like here's your choice: you can land at like that little spot by Coney with the bushes and stuff, that farm, and you can land at that from that mountain. Just land somewhere where like nobody would land, because you could get a lot of placement just staying in the middle of nowhere getting placement points. Now, and you can be camping in like a bush or something if someone comes up to you. You could shoot them without them even noticing. So, like say, I don't know, do the first step. Like, I shouldn't land like Tilted, Coney, 50, Sleeper, Daily, or any of these. Except for what I can land is like here, or like land here. So, but we're gonna land right. Where should we land? Let's land right here. You see, that's like in the middle. Sorry, that's my controller vibrating. So, and the second step to play before is you need to. You have to have the game. So a lot of people that are doing this, because some people play on keyboard and play competitive for that. But some people play controller like me. And most controller players have anuses. But on keyboard, you're probably just gonna have to practice your aim more, because on competitive for that, most of the time you're gonna have to have good aim. And the third step is that you need to have at least 2 SMGs in your inventory. My friend Lep taught me this. He's pretty good at arena. I'm competitive for it. He plays arena all day. And that's a fact. His YouTube channel is like 32, so like 32 or whatever. And yeah, you need to have at least 2 SMGs in your inventory, right? Because nowadays, in like solos or anything competitive for it, a lot of people spam a lot. So that's why they have like, mostly like 2 SMGs in your inventory, or at least one or something. Just have an SMG. And then the fourth step is that I'll go on the fourth. I don't know which one I'm on, but I'm just gonna do it for the fourth. The fourth step is that you need to have hills. Because if you don't have hills, if you get shot at, you can't get up or anything. So they're just gonna rush you, push you, and then you're gonna die because you don't have any hills. This step is that, what is it called? You need to jump around when you're walking around to go to different places. I kind of just jump around. Because the reason why you jump around and stuff like this is because you don't want people to snipe you. Because if you just don't stay off this side, you can just snipe me like you did. All it takes is one heavy sniper and a bullet to the head that I'm already dead. And so you need to jump around so you can't get sniped, so people can't snipe you. Oh, I thought I heard a guy. But I think that's pretty much all I'm for now. I think we're just gonna be playing Fortnite on TikTok, and then I'm gonna end the video. So I'm just gonna say, make sure to subscribe and use my creator code SGIZZY, and check out my new map. I just got this. And yeah, so let's go ahead. So where should we go? Let's go inside this building right here. I always see these like sanctuary buildings. I don't know why. I'm gonna go to Max. See what we got here. Honestly, I think we should just camp up here, but we gotta go to circle at the same time. Yeah, we gotta go to circle. Storm is gonna come in a minute. So let's go ahead and mark circle. It's not that far away from us. It's only 200 meters away, so. Yep. And yeah. Okay. So this is actually us on controller. We have a system. So it's kind of an advantage from keyboard players because, yeah, I'm in the East by the way, but yeah, we have, hold on, where is it? Maybe not that, not that. Oh, wait, it's in here. But these are all my settings if you just want to, you know, look at them for a little bit. Wait, bro, I'm slagging. So yeah, these are pretty much all our settings and stuff, but yeah, we have an advantage. We have aim assist strength, which is right here, and keyboard players don't have that. What aim assist strength is, it basically like drags, like when you aim, like almost if you drop the die, like it basically like drags when you aim like that to the person you're trying to aim to. And hold on, I have to, oh my god, I didn't even really move it up. I have to reset something, I messed up something in my settings. Oh no, I shouldn't have did that. Alright, reset. But where's that? Honestly, I think I should just, oh my god. Yeah, I must have watched those off it after this, but I might end the video now because, instead of the messed up, but I hope you enjoyed it. It's a cool computer, so I can't edit on computer. But, yeah, so subscribe and like, that's probably my longest video. See you next time, guys. Bye.